Excuse us. This way. I would rather you hadn't seen this. I'm sorry. We have urgent tidings. Oh, no, no, I'm not angry with you. On the contrary. I know full well how hard everyone has been searching for a way to return home. And I had hoped to afford you the time you needed. But given our friend's present state, perhaps it was for the best that you came. Stiff and cold. All of them, as if they were made of wax. Barely alive at all. Been doing so well. Save for occasional signs of etheric instability, they appeared to be in passable health. Then, quite without warning, things took a turn for the worse, a change for which even Master Matoya could offer no explanation. She could only remind me that the soul is yet an unknown frontier. And that much and more lies beyond our ken. But let's not lose heart just yet. At times like these, it is all the more important that we remain positive. Why, I but this moment succeeded in quelling a fluctuation in Thancred's ether. And while the others have weakened, they have remained relatively stable. I believe I may leave my post for a moment. So come, let me hear your tale outside. Thank you.
Forgive the delay.
We have visited every region and confirmed the presence of Ascians throughout the realm.
Lest a grave predicament be made to seem hopeless, it should be noted that they are of inferior rank, the black-masked minions who answer to the Red.
Yes. A gaggle of schemers attempting to exploit recent events to sow the seeds of petty conflict. Fortunately, nothing of any great concern has come of their meddling just yet.
We also encountered a number of the Crystarium's former defenders, busily solving this problem and that in a bid to become Warriors of Light.
Their zeal is to be applauded. It is but a pity I cannot encourage them on their course.
Not knowing Elidibus set them upon it, no. Both the troubles to be solved and the villains to be vanquished are his doing too, like as not. And so, with apologies to the aspiring Warriors of Light, I believe it best that we deal with the Ascians quickly and quietly.
I quite agree.
But tell us, what news from the source? How fare our bodies? Oh dear. Then we must redouble our efforts. Not that we've ever stinted in that regard.
This would seem an appropriate moment to ask about the spirit vessel. Tell me you've made some progress.
We have, as it happens. One moment.
The red stones. Then this doth mean...
For the benefit of all, permit us to explain. As you will recall, using white aurasite as our starting point, we fashioned a vessel for mind and memory both. Yet, though it served this purpose admirably, the process of imbuing it with one's complete essence proved a somewhat thornier proposition. Simply put, the memory would not accompany the mind. And so, we looked to the Allegan's mastery of memory transference for a solution.
This approach was not without its own complications, however, relying as it does upon blood, which inanimate objects notably do not possess. We duly explored methods of suffusing the vessel with drops of the aforementioned. Alas, our painstaking experimentation succeeded only in making me feel faint, and singularly failed to imbue the crystal with the necessary properties. It was the...
You're doing this for our sakes. So far be it from us to complain. But don't think we haven't noticed what's happening to your arm.
It falls well short of offering up my life in exchange for yours, which was your only stipulated prohibition, as I recall. And it is but a small price to pay for delivering you home.
Assuming it works. We shall soon know if this grisly addition will serve as a suitable conduit for the subject's memory. Though not soon enough to warrant your waiting, the test is like to take a while.
Let us be off then. We have Ascians to attend to, among other things.
Forgive me, but I count 6 vessels. And there are only 5 of us.
One is for testing purposes. I will personally use it to see whether the crystal functions as it should.
And if it does, wouldn't that mean that your soul could also return to the source?
Yes. In theory, at least. But there is a distinct difference between your circumstances and mine. While your corporeal forms want for souls, my past self does not. Mayhap our essences would blend, or mayhap they would curdle. There is no telling what might occur.
And you'd be willing to take that risk?
I would.
I see.
Excellent. I had intended to speak with you alone. None of my doing, lest you misunderstand. The link between her body and soul wavers. I know not what you hoped to find here, but it will avail you naught to learn of our past. It fades. Fades away into oblivion. Does the world no longer have need of me? No. I am Elidibus, and I will fulfill my duty. Sundered though you may be, you fought for the world's salvation. For hope. Hope. Ah, it swells within me, empowers me. Now I may carry out my mission. And yet, why do I yearn for this? Why do I struggle so? I shall take her into my safekeeping. If you want her back, you will do as I ask. show me your strength, I would take your measure. I have prepared a suitable arena. You need but ride the flow of ether. You have grown stronger since last we fought. The result of your trials in the first, no doubt.
Have you finished? My apologies. I freed myself as soon as I awoke, but rather too late, I see. Now, Elidibus, if you have ceased trading blows, I would trade words with you. I have a theory, you see. One concerning that which you seek to accomplish. It stems from who, or rather what, you truly are. A primal. The ancients created Zodiac to deliver the star from destruction. If the magic that brought him forth is the precursor of what we know as summoning, then Zodiac would have been instilled with a presiding desire. I found it among the records at Anada, and it came as no surprise. Were I faced with the world's destruction, I too would wish for the same. Salvation. I know that you sacrificed yourself to become Zodiac's heart. How you came to be separated from him is less clear. But if you are a fragment of his being, it stands to reason a desire for the world's salvation would drive you. And thus did you seek to inspire the masses to rise up as warriors of light, going so far as to use Ardbert as a symbol of hope.
Correct on all counts. Such is my nature, and such are my methods. I have aided heroes. I have made them. I have even become them. This served not only to strengthen me, but also to facilitate the work of my brothers, such as Emmett Selk, with his penchant for nation-building.
Then you will be all too familiar with the fickleness of mankind. We change, we forget, and what little we do remember becomes twisted and fragmented over time. For which reason? You deem us unfit to carry on your legacy. But are you yourself free of these foibles? As the last witness of the final days, do you remember everything that was lost? Or even the things you cared about?
Get to the point.
A primal is shaped by the hope that fuels it. Even should this hope be something as simple as the world's salvation, it is the collective desire of innumerable disparate souls crying out for deliverance. Having drawn your strength from such a cacophony of voices, can you truly be sure you still speak with your own?
Your question is irrelevant. No matter how much I should change, no matter how much I should forget, I shall ever remember my duty. At times I stand with my brethren. At times I stand against them. All that I might steer mankind and the very star upon their true course. For Elidibus is my name and my mission, guiding my every deed. You have shown me sufficient proof of your might. As I am now, I would struggle to defeat you. Yet I have still to play all of my cards. If I could offer you some semblance of sport, your lessers would pose no threat to me. Would you not agree, warrior of darkness?
Thank you. Thank you. I was wondering where you'd disappeared to. Is something troubling you? No? Very well. I have everything. Let's hurry back to the surface. Forgive us our lateness. Master Chai, my congratulations on your appointment. By all accounts, you are a capable mayor.
Oh, I have capable friends, my lady. I must say, it's good to see you looking hale and whole again.
The credit for that lies with my own capable friend, without whom I might never have escaped my abductor.
That would explain why Elidibus has been fostering faith in the Warrior of Light. While you were enjoying your audience with the Wandering Heart of Zodiac, we were busy dispatching the last of the Black Master Ascians.
A task which proved almost insultingly easy. Formidable though we undoubtedly are, they were obviously sent to provide encouragement for budding heroes. One cannot help but wonder how many times the ploy has been used before.
Master Chai, you mentioned that the people of Calusia are similarly enamored of the Warrior of Light.
Indeed, though it's hardly surprising given the state of the world. Many are still struggling to find a purpose, and it's only natural that they should take comfort in the tales.
Then the fever has spread to every corner of Norvrant. We may have dealt with his black-masked minions, but it is plain Elidibus has yet to show his hand.
Oh my! What a spectacular sky!
Another star shower.
Wait, is that... Amarant?
Yeah.
Did you hear that? That voice calling out?
No, I didn't hear anything, but... Why do I feel so... like I've lost something dear to me?
Does Elidibus seek to awaken more people to the Echo with clearer visions of the final days?
Those that the Exarch did employ in our summoning.
Are you saying the Exarch is summoning them?
Nay, yet the similarity can be no mere coincidence.
Retreat to the Crystarium! The ether churns around us. More of them will appear ere long. To stay would only place innocents in harm's way. We must fight this battle elsewhere.
Wait! Take one of our airships. You can decide what to do on your flight to the Crystarium.
You are a capable leader in your own right, Master Chai. The citizens of Yulmore chose well.
It's settled then. To the airship!